what do you guys need to do to find more consistency on the offensive end?
Well, we had looked at it in the second half. I mean, you got to make some, you know, nights, some nights you shoot it, some nights you don't. And, you know, we had good looks at it. And, you know, I wish we could coach making shots, but you can't. But it was the exact kind of game I thought it would be. You know, you're playing against one of the slowest playing teams offensively in the country. You knew they were going to take it deep into the shot clock every time. You knew they were going to be extremely physical trying to get to the glass. You knew they were going to run through every screen. They're going to be physical on that end. They have depth. They're not concerned about fouling, you know. Not that they do any more than we probably do when we're trying to be physical. But, I mean, it's exactly the game that we thought it would be. Started out, we stood around, didn't have our spacing. It was all about spacing. Wasn't ready to move the ball like we had talked about for a couple days. And then second half, you know, when we had chances to stretch it out, we had some great looks at it and didn't make it. Got to pass the ball better. And but the word you use there, consistency, we've got to get that more from just knowing what guys are going to do. We can't have, you know, guys that bounce the ball more than three times. I mean, you get in trouble against a team like this. I mean, that's a two-bounce game, really, and a two-dribble game. But I'm telling you, it's exactly the way I thought the game would play. It's the way it played.
Coach, in the back here, first of all, congratulations on your nomination. Just what does it mean to you?
Well, what it means, you know, this is a team game, and I've been blessed. The good Lord has looked after me for a long, long time, even way back when I probably was growing and trying to figure out how to be a head basketball coach. But it's always been about the players. It's always been about our staff. I mean, I've always tried to pride myself in hiring people that I thought was better than me. I think that when you're in a leadership position, you got to be someone that's willing to learn something every day. And the way you do that, you surround yourself with great people. And obviously, it's not just your coaches. It's everybody in the organization. And then my family, you know, they've stuck with me. I mean, I think I've made 10 different moves over the years. But again, I'm just thankful that the good Lord's, he's blessed me in ways that I can't even imagine. But anytime you're involved in a team sport and you're singled out for something, it always goes back to it's a team sport, and it's all those that have helped you along the way and been there with you along the way. And they're as much a part of it as anybody.
Go Grant, Rob, Mike, Reese.
What do you got to do to get Dalton to snap out of this?
Well, I think he's going to have to understand if he's not shooting the ball, he can impact games other ways. And I think if he'll, again, I think he's always put his, you know, everything into scoring the ball. And he is seeing some things that he's never seen before in terms of the physicality and heavy gaps. But he doesn't have to score it. He just needs to make good plays. And he's capable of doing, because there's nothing he can't do. He can pass it. And believe me, once he starts making those kind of hockey assists, those Gretzky's where he makes the pass that leads to the basket, that's when things will change. When people have to make an adjustment, because he's not going to always be able to catch the ball and hop. He hops too much on the perimeter and think he's going to get downhill with it. You know, we try to move him around and put him in different positions, but you know, he's got a big target on his back. But he's going to he can't let the fact he's not making shot impact the other end of the court. I mean, he's going to have to figure out how to get fouled. He's going to have to figure out how he can run the court and get some easy buckets that way. He's going to have to understand that he can go offensive rebound, score that way. If he's just going to wait and think he's going to score it every time he has the ball in his hand, he is going to be frustrated. And it's going to affect him that way. But a game like this, again, when we put together a schedule – like this, we knew exactly what we were getting with Tarleton State. We knew what we were getting with NC State. And we knew that those teams are teams that really, really pressure hard. They're real physical, and they're trying to see that you can make one-on-one plays. And then, obviously, as the year goes on, everybody plays analytics and they play scouting report. And that's what they're doing with him right now. So he's going to – it's all new to him. Believe me, he's never had this type of athlete. And it's only going to intensify as we continue into the SEC.
Coach, essentially played eight guys tonight. Cade and JP played a little in the first half. Are you comfortable with that? And
yeah.
What do you have? What do the other guys have to do?
We're going to win games. I mean, we can't afford to lose this game in any way, shape, or form. I mean, these games. I mean, every game's an NCAA tournament game, and it's not just about winning. It's about playing the right way. And what I've told the young guys. It's all about them learning how to play defense at the caliber we want them to play. That's what we want to see. And so you think about it, you're asking me about playing. We got to get Dalton going. We got to get Jordan Ganey going where he's going. We got to get Jemiah Mashak playing. Like, this is a tough game for him, the way they're guarding. You know, and again, those other guys, again, we'd like to see them get out there some. We would, but, I mean, it's not just the young guys. It's consistency. You know, somebody asked about the consistency. That's what we've been talking about all year. And so that's what we're trying to get done. The most consistent guy the last two games has been Sakai. And I think we put a lot on him. And he needs help from some other people.
What is it about Dalton that leads you to believe he can kind of snap out of this recent funk and get back to where he was? And is he healthy at this point?
He's not totally. He's not. I mean, he and Jordan Ganey aren't totally healthy. They both actually, you know, we thought Jordan's ankle turn was worse than Dalton's in the Carolina game. He just didn't say anything about it until the next day. But he's not, and that has something to do with it. But hopefully these next 5 days he can get healthy. And everybody needs a break right now. We've traveled a lot. We played a lot of big games and hard games. I mean, think about it. We've played some hard games, different styles. Again, this was a style tonight where, again, you go back, teams holding the ball, trying to make it a low possession game. And the bottom line, you got to grind it out. And in a low possession game, every possession matters, every one of them. And it goes kind of, I think, what Rob's asking, when those guys are going to get out there. Again, they understand we got to win games. And we got to get everybody playing well, especially those older guys that have been here. And then if they'll work in practice, do what we need them to do, there will come a time they'll, again, it's a long way to go. And they are improving, I will tell you that. It's being able to sustain it for long periods of time. And again, the older guys could help those guys by being more consistent. If we know what we, again, we can't start the game turning the ball over the way we did against a team that we talked about 2 days. You know, you can't pick up your dribble, you can't stand and hold the ball over your head and stare it down. You got to move the ball. I mean, they're just waiting to jump on passes and get into gaps. And so, again, consistency is where we've got to improve.
Is Dalton, like, what about him makes you think that he can snap out of this and figure out who he is?
Well, again, he's a good teammate. He wants to win. Does he want to play? Yes. And again, his teammates, they're pulling for him. They're going to help him. But the one thing about our team, you guys have watched us win a lot of games like we had to win it tonight. You know, we are defense at the end. Really, defensively, we did a great job. For the most part, again, Jonas is going to have to work on when those smaller guys get down below him and push him in. I think Tobe's gotten better and better. I think every minute he plays is going to help him. Again, I look at the two young guys we put in there tonight for a couple minutes because as time goes on, we're going to need those guys. And then again, it's hard to get past eight guys really when you play the schedule we play when you've been in so many possession games like we've been in.
Coach in the back here, a couple days ago you said Tobe Awaka has to understand spacing a little bit better in order to get his offensive game to reach the next level. What does he have to understand about the spacing in order to reach that next
level? Well, again, get his space and then knowing the collapse. Like Jonas tonight, we had a couple good dump offs and those guys were too slow getting the ball from the chin to the rim. And again, we talked about it. Said they're going to be in there tight. They're going to slap, grab, get a rebound. They're going to come after it. It's dealing with physicality. And we're in a league that's known for physicality. And as Tobe rolls and knowing that there's going to be somebody coming from somewhere. I mean, teams, if you put them in a roll situation and down below, you know, if those guys want the ball, they're going to have to work hard. I give Tarleton a great job. The kid down there, I thought, played his butt off, wasn't letting him catch the ball, outworked him on both ends, really, when you think about it. But it's hard to get that position. But with that, when they do get it, the guards have to be ready to deliver it, which at the end of the game a couple of times, Tobe did get it where he wanted it right in front of the rim, but it still should have gotten there quicker.
Rick, I know you pride yourself on a tough non-conference schedule. When you're trying to find teams to schedule, are you looking for those specific traits that you mentioned earlier about on-ball pressure and how teams defend the ball the way that NC State and Tarleton State have, and how much is that going to help in SEC play?
Well, that's what, again, there's a lot of teams in the SEC that play like this, you know, and is going to play like this. And again, everything we do is trying to get us ready for conference play because as tough as it is, you get in the game. I mean, one of the hardest things to do is to win a game. It's hard to win at home. It's really hard to win on the road in conference play. And But the fact is, you've got to, every game, I've said it many times, takes on its own personality. And I can, if you'd have sat down with me before the game, I would have told you this game was going to play exactly the way it played out. I didn't think, I thought that if we could guard them, which I thought we could keep them down where we did, but I knew we were going to have to make some shots. I think, again, we work hard. Coach Polinsky's taken it over, you know, through the years. Different coaches have had it, but he worked really hard. Again, what can we do, even in our bye games, what can we do to make sure we're going to get something out of it and not just, you know, try to beat somebody by 50 or 60 points? I mean, it's not good for anybody. And I think with the younger guys, going back to I think what Rob was asking, they I would like to think now understand how hard it is to win at this level. And I mean, I'm not sure they had ever heard of Tarleton State before this on the schedule. And those guys want to play too, and they can play. And again, everything we've done with our schedules to try to get us ready for SEC play.
Last two, Ryan and then Reese.
Tobe has played more in closing time, or played in closing time the last two games. Is that more about him or more about Jonas?
Both. You know, physicality. You go back to the last two games. Jonas has given up some points in there where bigger, stronger guys have been able to move him and put him where they want him. And that's something he'll have to continue to work on. And it's going to go down with getting leverage. He can't play straight up there. And those guys are smaller than him, shorter, but stronger in some ways. And they get down under him and they can move him. And then Tobe obviously is stronger. There's no doubt. You guys know he's stronger than Jonas, but Tobe's learning how to get down. And the best thing Tobe's starting to learn to do is how to switch, which will it'll bode well. That even gives us a chance when we go with a big lineup. We don't have to make as many adjustments with our defense the way we would, and it can stay with the packages that we like best.
Go to the back here again. What went into the decision going full court at the end of the game there?
Do what?
Going full court press at the end of the game.
We've done it. That's what we wanted. That's who we want to be. We want to play 94 feet. You know, we try to do it, but again, the problem with that is Z's normally the guy back there. If you go back to the NC State game, we spent a lot of time in the backcourt. Z did a great job in that game, but again, that's what I was talking about. We're putting a lot on him. Not only asking him to get there, and he needs to do that, and he likes to do that. But the other guys get up there, and it doesn't do him any good to work as hard as he tries to work on the ball, and guys just allowing a free outlet, letting guys run up and catch it. And again, we knew that when they crossed half court, I mean, they stood there a couple times at half court, you know, letting the clock come down. We knew that. And again, I thought offensive rebound-wise, we gave up more than we needed to. But you got to give them credit for that. They were aggressive going to get it.